Hi guys, I'm Amanda Calley and welcome back to Spilling the Black Tea. I've spoken before about the fact that in school we didn't get taught about Black British history. We did, however, get taught about the transatlantic slave trade in America. It's crazy to me that we got taught how involved America was in the slave trade, but nothing about Britain. So today we're going to talk about Scotland's involvement in the slave trade. More specifically, we're going to talk about Aberdeen's involvement in the slave trade. I love being Scottish. I think Scottish people are some of the funniest people ever, but we're also proud people. Proud to be Scottish and proud of our history, mostly. And there's nothing to be proud of when it comes to our history with the slave trade. So I understand why we don't speak about it, but that doesn't make it right. Our involvement gets brushed under the rug because of the uncomfortable truths that come with it. But it was years ago. Okay, and so was the Battle of Stirling Bridge, but we get taught that. It might be part of a more shadowy past, but it's still our history. We don't just get to pick and choose which pieces we want to remember. The northeast of Scotland's involvement was extensive, with prominent rural landowners profiting from ties to the Caribbean and southern states of America. There is even evidence that links the University of Aberdeen and chattel slavery. So let's go. I went to university here and at the time I had no idea about the links. I've literally walked past this area multiple times. This is the Powys Gate. Whilst it appears harmless enough, it's a very tangible link between the university and slavery that's kind of hidden in plain sight. The gate was funded by the Leslie family after they received compensation when slavery was abolished. That will never not blow my mind, that people were compensated for no longer enslaving humans. This is Sugarhouse Lane, possibly the only place in Aberdeen that you'll be able to find a sign that highlights the city's involvement in the slave trade. The sign says that in 1766, a sugar house was established here, where raw sugar from the Americas was refined for sale. It states that this sugar house was just one of several businesses in Aberdeen that was involved in the transatlantic trade of slave-produced goods. Sugarhouse Lane was eventually formed on the ground which once belonged to the Sugarhouse Company. Along the road, just south of Fraserburgh, sits Cairness House. Charles Gordon of Buthlaw and Cairness was an absentee slave owner and proprietor of the Georgia Estate in Jamaica, where sugar and rum were produced on a large scale. It was Charles Gordon who commissioned Cairness House, using the profits from the estate and the enslaved people. It might be an uncomfortable truth, but Scotland was very much involved in the slave trade. But what about the African chiefs who sold slaves? What about them? We're not talking about those countries and their involvement. We're talking about our country, and more specifically, Aberdeen. Just because other people were involved in the slave trade doesn't absolve Scotland of its guilt. We can't just erase a whole period of history because it makes us look better. In fact, brushing it under the rug makes us look worse. It happened. We'll never be able to take it back. However, ignoring the problem just adds to Scotland's shame. Anyway guys, I'm all out of tea, so I'll see you next time for more.